No discussion of PyAce is going to be complete without talking about the PyModule database. The PyModule database is a hierarchical database. It's integrated with the Py server and has been since April 2001, version 3.3 of the server, and it's controlled by the base subsystem. It's a scalable, secure database, and it provides structure for organizing plant information. And that's really the key word there, is organizing. The PyModule database provides a hierarchy to your data. Here's a sample of a organization that has created a module database, and they've gone all the way from the enterprise level down to individual pieces of equipment. And this might be referred to as a physical or business model. It really doesn't matter how you set it up. But what this does is it allows people to find data without having to memorize hundreds or thousands or maybe even tens of thousands of tag names. I'd be willing to bet that anybody that deals with this heat exchanger probably knows what tags are on that heat exchanger and what you're measuring, and maybe even the tag names by heart. But anybody that's not a process engineer or technician or an operator that deals with that particular piece of equipment is going to know those details. And yet the information that's being tracked there might be relevant to a lot of different people in the organization. And so while the user of the whatever client tool you're using might not have that tag name memorized, I'd be willing to bet that they could understand what data they're going to get or even find this heat exchanger by drilling down through their business units, divisions, and locations down to a specific piece of equipment. That's an intuitive model that allows people to find information. And what we're going to see in the next few lessons, the next few segments here, is how to tie real-time information to this module database and how the users might use this in the client tools to find data. Now, all that sort of brings back around to ACE, in that ACE uses the same sort of hierarchy, the same sort of information in its calculations. And what we mean by that is that you can develop one calculation not using a tag name per se for the input, but by using an alias or a context. You can apply that same calculation across many different modules through a few simple point and clicks with the mouse, as opposed to developing individual calculations, compiling them, registering them, and scheduling them. So the PyAce application can use the PyModule database to, in a sense, automate or propagate its calculations across many different areas and layers of the organization. One of the questions we often get in most of our classes is, what is a Py module? What is this module and the module database? And there is a very lengthy, formal description of it. But the way we like to look at it in training is, a Py module is a context point. It is something that gives a meaning to an otherwise disconnected tag. We'll see what we mean by that in a few moments. The modules themselves are nice because they are standard. There aren't different types of modules. There's, you know, basically just the one kind of module, and it has methods and properties. They're interchangeable. Every module can represent different things. Modules can represent similar things. You can even use instances of the modules in more than one location in the hierarchy. So if you want to set up a view based on equipment, you can do that. You can also have another view side by side with that based on process. And so the module can live in different places and still reference the same tags or same points. Each module is a component in a hierarchical collection, which means that users can use their mouse and click and drill down through that hierarchy. And we do provide programmatic access to the module database. So if somebody wants to use it in similar to the way ACE does in a programmatic function, they can do that. That's perfectly okay. Now each module is going, it does have a lot of information associated with it, like version number and ID and things like that. But what we're going to be mostly associating ourselves with and concerned with is are these two items here, Py properties and Py aliases. And these are places to put various pieces of information that will help applications like PyAce to run the calculations and operate more efficiently and easily for the users.